Hi folks, what we're doing today is I want to show you different types of lids. And to begin with, I'm going to show you how to make a pot with a lid all in one shot. And what I've done here is I've just thrown a regular kind of rounded bowl-like form. And now, right in this area here, I've left it extra thick. So from this point here to the inside wall, it's probably about a half an inch across. And now by taking the rest of what I have left here and then throwing it up and coddling it in, I'll be able to close in the top just the way I would with a bottle. And that way we can come in with a needle on an angle and cut a lid right in one shot. So you'll have one pot plus lid done in one sitting on the wheel instead of using a second throwing to get the lid. You gotta be careful because I made the walls in here thin enough on the bottom part that if I squeeze it too tight, I can get some twists. And we really want to avoid that if we can. You want to make sure all your hand movements are slow when you're taking them off the pot, because if you take your hands off a little too quick, you can throw the pot back off center. Now I've closed this up enough so that the bottle is now sealed at the top, and now all I have to do is come in and my needle on an angle right in this area right here, and we should have our pot finished. Pot with lid. Okay, now this is a real touchy point here. It might be a good idea to slow your wheel down some, because you gotta keep a nice steady hand for this particular action. And you want to take it on about a 45 degree angle.
Okay,
So later on, what I'll do is after this stiffens up, I'll be able to lift the lid up, clean it up a little bit, and make sure that everything's okay with it. And then we'll have a pot with a lid right on it. But first, I want to do a little bit of trimming here. Let me just take this off here so you can see how I do this. Come in backwards with this particular tool here. Slowly turn it. Now use this end, the back of it, instead of the front end because it seems to cut better when you're doing that position. Then I turn around the front way and use this section here to come against the back. I'm going to get the rest of it off. Come in like this. Lid in one shot. And as I said, later on after this all cleans up, then I'll be able to come in here and touch it up and make sure everything's okay. Now I want to show you another type of lid, probably one of the more basic lids that you'll ever see. Just a regular flat lid with a handle, probably one of the ones that you'd want to start off with to begin with. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to basically open this clay up the same way I would a normal piece of clay, but I'm going to keep the hole very narrow right down through the center instead of opening up a wide bottom. And now I'm going to come in here from the side and I'm just going to kind of cleave into it like so. Want to keep it moist. See, I had to go back for water, and that was because it was starting to get away from me there a little bit because it sticks to my fingers. And I'll stick to anyone's fingers that way. Okay, now move this clay down. Slow the wheel down at this point a little bit. And I'm going to press the clay now towards the inside area of the pot. So you're not just pulling the clay out to the outer edge, but you're also moving the clay towards the inner edge. And it's a good idea when you do this with this type of lid and also with plates. Because if you keep pulling out towards the outer edge, then you're stretching the molecules out, particles of clay, rather, and the ones in the center are not as close together, so in the drying process, it can cause some cracking. Now, by taking our calipers, we can make a measurement here, and you don't have to necessarily make a lid to match a pot. You can also make a pot to match a lid, just as long as you have a record of it, the size you want. So what you want to do is carefully come down like this and get the calipers to run on its own line. And once you've done that, then you can come up like this. Come in with your needle. cut down to the back. And again, you can come in with this tool here. Cut it off, and now you have a flat lid with a handle. Okay, now I want to show you another type of lid that you can make. This lid is for a larger pot, so we're going to give it a dome shape, and I'm going to throw the dome upside down. But at the same time, I'm also going to be showing you how you can throw this domed lid upside down, and at the same time leave enough clay underneath so you come back the next day or whenever it gets to be leather hard, trim it down, and then you'll have a lid with a handle on it again in one shot. So we'll go right ahead with that. Now I've opened up the clay already, but I haven't gone down nearly as far as I normally do. Got about an inch and a half distance between the bat and the bottom of the hole. So now I'm just going to start bringing this clay out. Now make sure you keep it moist, otherwise it can get away from you. Show you how I finish off the edges of lids. I like to run it against the back of my fingernail, and by doing that I'm able to get a nice flat spot. And I like to have a lid that matches a flat with a flat, so that you'll have a flat area on the lip of your pot and a flat area on the lid. And when you do it that way, one of the advantages that you have is that if you're using the pot for cooking, it works as its own seal. I'm just going to clean it up a little bit in here. Come in here with a little metal kidney or rubber kidney too, and it'll help get a nice smooth area. And then we'll come back to this form a little later after it stiffens up, and then I'll show you how you can trim it down and have a handle using the clay that's underneath here already. I wanted to show you a lid very similar to the other one. This is another pretty basic lid. It's going to be another domed lid, but this one we're not going to leave enough clay underneath it to put a handle on just out of one big piece of clay. On this one, I'm just going to open it up, make a nice lid. And then from that point on, we'll let it stiffen up and trim it down. Then we'll put an extra handle on later after the clay is stiffened. Okay. this time you can go closer to the bat. I think it's a good idea to take your time. Don't try to rush it too much. Yeah, we can kind of come in with our rubber, metal kidney or rubber kidney, either one, and clean up. Again, I'm going to use the back of my fingernail to get a nice horizontal here. And again, we'll come back to this particular lid after it sets up, and then we can put a handle. Okay, now we're going to do another type of lid. This is going to be another domed lid, but we're going to do it right side up. So it'll be similar to the one that we did. It was one pot and one lid all in one shot. But this time we're just going to do a lid all at one time. So I'm going to open it up pretty normally. And then I'm going to go inside, and when I go inside, I'm going to actually turn my hand and go all the way back like this, so I'll be going underneath. Thank you. I have to keep this nice and moist, otherwise I can blow it. This is real touchy right here because you can get it too thin and it'll pop off. Whenever you're doing this type of lid, sometimes if you don't get the hole closed right down in the center, you may have a problem with that. And it really depends on what you want to use the lid for. Now this is just going to be for a jar form, but if you were going to use it for a casserole, you might even want to leave a little hole in the top to let the steam get out. Okay, once you get this far, then what you want to do is you want to trim down the sides. So I'm just going to use the back side of my needle right here. After you make a decision on how far the calipers are going to be touching, and like I say, you don't necessarily have to make a lid to match a pot. You can make a pot to match a lid. So now you can come in with a vacuum needle just like this, and just kind of press it down. Now, by carefully coming in from the side with my needle, you can actually cut this off the clay mound. And after it stiffens up later, then you just lift it right off. Okay, now I want to show you probably what will be the most difficult lid for you to deal with, and that's a drop lid. It's usually used for teapots. Now, what I do is I always center a little bit too much clay because I find it easier to center a little larger piece of clay than I'm going to actually need for the lid. because a little tiny piece of clay gets lost in my hand. So I'll be trimming down the clay as I work. But what we do is we start off normally, just like you would with a normal piece of clay. About 3/8 of an inch from the bottom. Now I'm going to come in right about here. Start coming down, taking my time, making sure I have enough moisture so it doesn't catch my hand. Said, I'm going to start trimming some of these pieces down. This is a lot of clay here. Be real careful when you cut that outer ring off, because it wants to jump around and grab the inner ring. Coming in with our calipers, and with this particular type of pot, you have to, or lid, you have to come in from the side. You can't come down on it because this is the area you're going to want to be fitting. Thank you. want to get kind of an angle so that the bottom part of the lid is a little narrower as you come up. And now we can just turn this over. Like so. So you can see how I'm holding my finger. Again, I'm using the upper part of my fingernail as a guide. For the outer edge, then you have one final trim, which is coming straight down. And by taking your sponge, clean up that edge. And you have a drop lid for a teapot. Type of lid. This is going to be another drop lid, but it's going to also be a kind of a domed lid at the same time. And it's different from the other one that we just saw because this one is going to be thrown upside down while the other one was thrown right side up. It has a similar beginning. But I'm just going to move it out a little bit more. And then come in, which again is similar, but I'll show you in just a second what's going to be different about it. This time, this will be the interior area right here. It's being thrown upside down. So all we want to do is just kind of finish off this edge right here. And we've got another type of drop lid, but this is, I think, better for things like jars instead of teapots because you have this big flange out on this area here. Okay. So what we can do is by taking our trimming tool, we can start trimming it already this way. And then by coming in, by letting this particular one dry for a while, then after it stiffens up, we can turn it over, trim it like we would the bottom of any bowl or plate, except you won't have any rings down there. You just trim it off, and then you'd have a lid. Earlier I threw this lid upside down for you, and this is the one where I'm going to show you how you can trim down and actually have a handle made out of the same piece of clay that you actually threw the lid from. So what I'm doing now is I've let the clay set up some. Now I'm going to trim down some of the clay. I want to take my time. I don't want to go too fast, because if it grabs my tool, then I could be in real trouble. I'm using two different types of trimming tools here. A paracord and this rounded traditional type of trimming tool. Okay, now at this point, I'm going to cut it off the wheel. Show you right here what I'm doing is I'm putting it on another bat. I'm going to take the original one. And just clean it just a little bit over here. Turn this upside down, like so. And you have your piece upside down on this. And I'm going to kind of eyeball it, because I have this hole here and another one over here, and that looks just about equal on the outside. Plus, I'm going to spin it around a little bit and see if it's pretty much centered. So you can tell by running it against you there, it's a little bit off. Right there. And this smudge here tells me that that's the side that needs to be pushed over. I'll push that over. Too much. And we'll see how it is right now. Okay, that's pretty good. So, now I'm going to take some of the clay that I trimmed off the bottom, which is going to be the top, and press it along the sides here just to hold it in place. Start trimming. I want to take it fairly slow. I don't want to go too quick. It's always better to take your time when you're trimming. Go a little too fast, the clay can grab the tool and cause a rip in the clay. I'll start in the center now because I'm going to take out part of the center. I think I'm going to want that big of a handle, so I'm going to trim it down a little bit. That way, needle. Thank you. close the number two. Okay, take a little more out of the center here. I just pressed a little bit there in the center just to get a feel for how much clay is still there. Because you don't want to trim all the way through. That's one of the things that everyone experiences when they're first starting out in ceramics, but it's one of the unhappy things that you don't like to repeat. Okay, now, the neat thing about this is the clay right here is still moist enough that I can actually form it a little with my hands. Same way I would if I was throwing on the wheel. I'm just going to take a little bit more out of the center area right here, and that should be it. And while I'm just showing you this, I just want to talk to you a little bit about glazing while we're doing this. One of the things that you can do with a handle with an open area like we have right here is you can take broken glass, break it up and put it in here, colored glass, like glass for stained glass windows and beer bottles and pop bottles that have color to them. And then when it's fired, it gives a nice accent to that open area in the middle of the handle. So that's another way that you can make a handle on a lid all at the same time. You're just doing it, throwing your lid, making the handle all in one shot. All you have to do is just turn it over, and it only takes a couple minutes, and you've got your lid done.
Okay, now I want to show you the other lid that I threw, one of the other ones we threw. This is similar to the one that I just trimmed, except that this one doesn't have enough clay here to actually trim a handle with the clay that's there. So there's two things we can do. We can make a hand-built handle and put it on there, or we can throw another little handle and set it on there and finish throwing it after we turn it over. First, we got to trim it down a little bit, like so. Pull most of that out. So we have less to deal with. Take this off, put it on another bat. Take my original bat. And just like we did last time, I put this over here. Turn this over. And we have our lid up right side up. And all we have to do is center it on here. Again, I'm going to run it against my finger. And it's real close, so I'll just go ahead with it the way it is. Thank you. Okay, just a little bit more here, and I have this pretty much ready to go. Okay, depending on how dry this is, you can apply a handle. This one, I could probably put on a hand-built handle right now and maybe wait a little bit longer in order to put on a wheel thrown handle. So I want to wait a couple minutes and put a wheel thrown handle on for you, so we'll be back in just a couple minutes. Okay, I want to go ahead and show you how to trim this one here. Already we've trimmed a little bit off when we threw it. Now I'm going to take some more off. Okay, put it here. So we're back on our original bat now, and again we're going to center this. Okay. Maybe just a little bit more and we're going to be done with this one. Okay. Another lid then. This one should be stiff enough you can handle it already. Okay, what I have here is I have a little piece of clay that I've just centered and opened up in the center a little bit. And I'm going to trim it off right now, and then I'm going to put it on to our trim dome, and then we're going to try to make that into a lid, and hopefully our dome will stand up to the pressure and we'll fall off, cave in. So I'm just gonna switch bats now. I'm ready. I'm going to set this on here so I can get an idea of where I'm going to score. I'm jiggling it a little bit Hoping to get it to adhere, starting to adhere now. And voila, we have a handle on our dome lid, type that you make separate.